Nous allons aborder enfin la troisième partie de cet exposé avec la synthèse en anglais. Sapho syndrome is a rare and recently described disease. The prevalence is about 400,000 people. Since 1960, some papers report patients with an association of neutrophilic dermatitis, osseous manifestations, pain and non-infectious osteitis, and arthritis. In 1987, a group of French researchers gave the name of Sapho for synovitis, acne, pustulosis, hyperostosis, and osteitis present at the same time in patients. The location of osteitis is characteristic of this syndrome, with pain and local inflammation involving anterior chest wall in the majority of cases, thoracic spine in about one-third of patients, sacroiliac joint in less than 50%, long bone in 20 or less 10% of patients, and mandible in 10% of patients. Skin manifestations are present in the majority of cases, pustulosis palmoplantar in half or two quarter of patients, pustular psoriasis in one third of patients, and less frequently, hidradenitis suppurativa or severe acne. The skin manifestation occurred either before or after the osteoarticular manifestation in quite half of the cases before, half of the cases after, which led to a more difficult diagnosis. On X-rays, the initial lesion is osteolysis with peripheral osteosclerosis and periostal reaction. Then occurred cortical thickening and hyperosteosis with narrowing of the medullary canal. Anterior chest wall is mainly involved. Spine also can be involved with possible vertebral compaction. You see here lesion on the clavicle at the internal part of the clavicle, and in the back of the picture, the osteosclerosis of the last two lumbar vertebra. Whole body imaging is necessary to evaluate the asymptomatic lesions. Scintigraphy or MRI could be used. MRI avoid irradiation exposure and could be easily repeated during follow-up. You see here on the bone scan scintigraphy, the lesion of the pelvis, the mandible, and the sternum, and on the right, the lesions of vertebra with body impaction and of the sternum. The histologic characteristics of bone lesions change over the course of the disease. In early stages, the inflammation is acute with infiltrate of polymorphonuclear cells, bone resorption and periosteal bone formation. And in later stage, the infiltrate is consistent of lymphocytes and plasma cells. The pathophysiology involves possible infection with Propionibacterium acnes, driving an inflammatory reaction through an innate immune dysregulation on a predisposed genetic background. The treatment of Sapho syndrome is mainly NSAIDs, in always first line therapy, but the efficacy is not sufficient in about half of the cases, leading to other treatment. Antibiotics were tried because Propionibacterium acnes was found on a bone biopsy culture, but the results of treatment with cycline or macrolide are not always present. DMARDs, conventional DMARDs were tried, sulfasalazine and methotrexate, but we have only a case report and no cohort treated, which allowed no definitive conclusion. Biologic therapy were also tried more recently, anti-TNF-alpha and JAK inhibitor, with some case report published with excellent results, but there is no therapeutic trio. Bifosphonates have also been used with positive result on a case report, but the modality of treatment with bifosphonate are not completely definite. The prognosis of Sapho syndrome remained relatively good, with monophasic and polyphasic disease in half of the cases, after some relapse remission definitive, but in half of the cases a chronic course is observed. In this case, IBD is associated in 10% of cases. Sirimo is an auto-inflammatory disease first described in 1972 by a Switzerland author, Gaydon, in children suffering from non-infection osteomyelitis. The pathophysiology associates innate immunity disorder with proved overproduction of inflammatory cytokine, mainly IL-1 beta, and underproduction of anti-inflammatory cytokines, IL-10. A genetic susceptibility is also present because there are CRMO found in monogenic disease, Magic syndrome, which is caused by lipin 2 mutation with loss of function, and DIRA syndrome, which is secondary to loss of function of IL-1RN. Also, family cases are described in siblings or in parent and child. CRMO diagnosis is one of exclusion. It is necessary to exclude tumors, infection, and other inflammatory disease. Two sets of criteria are used. Johnson criteria, which defined major and minor criteria, and the diagnosis is confirmed by the presence of two major or one major and three minor criteria. The CRMO affect mainly a female, mean age 10 years. The pain are mainly located on long bone in the lumbar, in the femoral and tibial metaphyses. And the number of lesions is about 2 to 4 by patients. About one third of patients have vertebral lesions. Mandible and clavicle could also be involved. The X-rays imaging is characteristic, located on the metaphyses or metaphyso-epiphyses region, with osteolysis and osteosclerosis. Sometimes hyperostosis could be observed mainly in the clavicle. Total body MRI is a better exam to detect all the location. It is reproducible without irradiation and could be done every 1 or 2 years to follow the evolution. The biopsy is rarely necessary, only in monofocal presentation or atypical diaphyseal involvement. In early stages, the infiltrate is constituted by polymorphonuclear. In later stage, it is a lymphocytes and plasma cell infiltrate associated with fibrosis and sclerosis. The Eurofever cohort contains near 500 of patients, mainly female, 3/4 of female, mean age at onset about 10 years, with a delay of diagnosis about 1 year, mean clinical lesions at onset of 4 by patients. About 30% of patients have an unifocal form on MRI at the onset. Only 20% of patients have dermatological lesions at onset. 30% of patients had arthritis, and less than 10% IBD. The treatment is always NSAID at on first line, with an efficacy of about 70%. In the other cases, steroids or conventional DMARDs were tried. Biological therapy were tried in very few cases in this cohort. And in about 30 patients, bifosphonates were given, with, in all cases, a very good result on pain and radiological evolution. Take-home message is CRMO diagnosis must be evoked in a patient of more than 4 years complaining of bone pain. In the absence of specific biomarkers, diagnosis is based on typical pattern on X-rays, presence of multiple inflammatory foci on whole body MRI. Biopsy is necessary only in case of unifocal lesion or atypical imaging pattern. NSAIDs are effective in 50 to 70% of cases. Second line drugs are discussed, biologics or bifosphonate, because the pathology is inflammatory at onset, but is also hyper remodelage of bone. Prognosis seem to be good, but a long follow-up with whole body MRI are necessary. Thank you for your attention.